friends, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding a Brexit from economic wisdom written by Bhaskar Datta. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 3. Plus this is important for political science and economics optional students. Now this editorial is written with a troika of belief system. Now what is that troika of belief? The first belief that the Brexit that has taken place, it is the result of xenophobia. And the second belief that this will put England in economic misery. And third, it is not an end of globalization. So these are the three things that the writer has talked about in this editorial. Now according to writer, the Brexit has taken place just because of the feeling of xenophobia. Now what is this xenophobic feeling? Now this xenophobic feeling is a kind of a feeling in which one feels that the people from the other countries are taking away their jobs. That the people belonging to the other countries, they are eroding their benefits, their opportunities, their leeway, their freedom and their autonomy. So according to author, the xenophobia is the main reason that is led to the Brexit. Now is xenophobia the sole reason for this exit? The answer is big no. Now why the answer is no? Now why the people have actually opted for this Brexit? The people have opted for this Brexit because since this process of globalization, since this process of new public management, since this process of liberalization, privatization, globalization era has begun in Europe and in America, since the days of Reaganism and Thatcherism, this Thatcherism has led to the concentration of the resources in the hands of the corporations, big corporations, multinational corporations. Now these multinational corporations have sold people the idea of development. Now according to them, according to the corporate class, increase in the growth, increase in the rates of growth will lead to the percolation of profits to the bottom layers of the hierarchy where the poor people are lying. So this was the logic that was presented, that was sold, that was given, and this was the logic that it justified this entire process of globalization. Though globalization has led to many positives, it has given many benefits to the humanity, it has generated good fruits for the humanity, but the basic logic, the basic promise has remained quite elusive. The basic promise has not been fulfilled. So the Brexit is not solely the resultant of the xenophobic feeling. It is the resultant of how corporations, of how capitalist thing has actually failed. Now it is not about the sharing of the profits. It's not about the fear that the people of England are fearing of by sharing of the profits with the other people, with the people from the other countries, but they are more fearful, they are more disenchanted, they have more grievance towards the big banks, towards the capitalist policies, towards the capitalist ideologies and the corporate world, because it is this class of people that is led to generate another kind of belief system. Now, what is another kind of belief system? The belief system of austerity measures. Now, it is this class of people who wants people to, who wants government to toe the line of austerity. Now, why austerity? Because if government will not be towing the line of austerity, the funds, the credit from the big banks will not be available to this corporate class. And if it will not be available to this corporate class will not be able to sustain their position. Now, what position I'm talking about? The position of inequality. The position of monopolistic trade. The position of entrenching the inequitable inertia. Now, the second thing, according to Bhaskar Datta, it will put England under economic misery. Now, this writer, Bhaskar Datta, he is actually more inclined towards the capitalist ideology. He believes that the growth is more important vis-a-vis development. He has a belief system of the corporate class. Now, according to him, England will not be able to survive. It will lead to a kind of a doom and gloom situation in England. It will lead to the fly-off of the capital from England. Now, what all concerns he is trying to address through his editorial are only the concerns of the corporate class. He is not trying to highlight how doing away with the austerity measures will actually help in supporting the poor people, will actually help in succoring the poor people, will actually help in lending them the hand because of the sufferings they have been facing because of this enhanced corporatization of the world. Now, these companies like Apple, these companies like BMW, these companies like Sony, they have earned billions of dollars. The top 10,000 people in the world, they are amassing about 70% of the wealth. So the problem is not with the globalization. The problem is with how globalization has worked. The problem is with how these top 1,000 people have been forcing governments to adopt certain policies. The problem is not the globalization. The problem is not the interconnectivity. The problem is not the migration of the people. The problem is not loss of the jobs. The problem is new public management. The problem is Thatcherism, the way Thatcherism has unfolded. Now, the third thing, according to Bhaskar Datta, that this is not an end of globalization. He believes that this entire episode is just the resultant of a xenophobia. It is not the end of globalization. But again, what globalization should have been and what globalization is, there is a lot of difference. The globalization, in essence, should have meant the exchange of ideas. The globalization, in essence, should have meant generating higher standards of human welfare. Globalization, in essence, should have meant the welfare of the humanity. Globalization, in essence, should have meant the mitigation of poverty, the mitigation of inequality. Globalization, in essence, should have meant the welfare of the poor children. Globalization, in essence, should have meant raising and rising the standards of education. globalization in essence would have meant, should have meant, reducing the disparity. But in essence, what it has given to the people. Now, if globalization was so good a thing, why this global economic crisis has come into being? Why the governments are talking so much about austerity measures? Why the growth rates are not leading to the welfare of the humanity? Past 30 years, the growth rate on the planet called Earth has reached stupendous proportions. Now, why these stupendous proportions are not leading to the alleviation of poverty? So humanity needs to answer about the direction in which it wants to move, and it but must also ponder over the real questions that the humanity is facing. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on IAS Civil Services Preparation. You can also join the test series program for the prelims and for the mains. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care.